Frank Baltier is here with Rolling Burritos, a food truck here in the Chicagoland area. And I was thinking here, like, entrepreneurship, you know, so such a cool subject that has a lot of variables, right? There's no pay, no benefits, nothing like that. And I was like, is it something that you're born with that you really want to do when you're smaller and you want to build like this massive company because you grew up with possibly like no money in the family and you're like, man, I need to like do something really, really big? Well, that's like the case here. If you ever had that thought, you know, I know for us, I grew up as a Jehovah's Witness. And with that, like a lot of our focus was on the Bible and preaching and helping people in that aspect. And money was like something that if you have a lot of it, you're thought of as like a money lover, money hungry, you know, things like that. But I knew that I wanted to make my own money to have my own things. So I don't know if that's something that you guys have in your mind, like, you know what, I need to have like the opportunities to buy whatever I want. And I remember when I was smaller, I wanted a BMX bike. This was when I was like 12. Like, what year was that? 1997. That sounds like such a far, long time ago, because we're 2020. Crazy. But with that, I was thinking, I was like, you know what, back then I wanted a BMX bike because I like going backwards. You know when you used to have a bike and you kick the thing backwards and it stopped? I'm like, I need to have the option. Maybe that's where it's like I need to have the option of going backwards and not stopping and have the handlebars up here to brake. So with that, I was like, I need to have this bike. I want to have this bike. Or my parents didn't have a lot of money, or we had money enough to survive on a daily basis is what I know now. And I was like, how do I get this bike? So back then they had a thing in the paper that we used to get every day, which was a Fox Valley Shopper. They used to send coupons every day to you, and they have like the help wanted sections. And on one of the help wanted sections, it said, we're looking for newspaper carriers. And the pay was like, I would say like 50, 60, 70 bucks a week. I forgot, or a month. It was some crazy number like that. I don't remember, but at the end of the day, I know it took me a while to build $300 to buy this Dyno Air bike, and it had the three spokes on it, the black ones that said GT, and it was a like a burgundy and black. It was black with burgundy spots on it. I still remember the bike very clearly, which my brother pawned later in life, I found out, at Scallywag. I'm telling you, I told him he couldn't die, because I'm like, you owe me a bike back, man. Come back. But you know, it took a, I used my mom's Huffy bike, which had that bar that goes down, you know, because it was a woman's bike. That's when you knew a woman's bike and a men's bike, because a men's bike goes straight across the top and a woman's has that angle down. And I used my mom's bike. It was purple and pink. And I used her bike to deliver newspapers to make enough money to buy my Dyno Air. They used to deliver the papers in a big bundle on Monday. And then on Wednesday, you bundle them up into a piece of paper. Sorry, into a piece of plastic with the coupons and everything like that. And then you deliver them to a specific address list that they gave you. Because not everybody got this coupon paper. You had to, like, membership for it or whatever it was. And I made enough money to buy that Dyno Air bike, which I bought when the Bulls won a championship on a Friday. And I remember it clearly because after that, I went to the youth center to watch a movie in Plano, Illinois. So, those guys were about to crash. And so with that, you know, is it something that you're born with? Is something that you're built with? I just knew when I was little, I needed two things in my life with me every time, which was a map that State Farm gave every single month, every single year. They gave this map out, an atlas, and I used to love getting that. And the other one was, I love to have enough money to buy anything that I wanted, being $1, $2, $3. I liked having the option financially to buy anything that I desired myself with my own money that I made. So that's how my entrepreneurship started. But with that, Rolling Burritos is the venture that we're working on for 2020. Food Truck 2020, I like to call it. Serving really, in my opinion, right? Really delicious breakfast burritos with the highest qualities of ingredients that I can have. Vegan option will be on there. I'm looking for ideas on how to build a really good vegan option and a no carb option into that food truck. So with that, Alter Brewing will most likely be our first opening spot. The day, I don't know yet, but be on the lookout. RollingBurritosFoodTruck.com. Follow us on social media, the Instagram, the Facebook. that's where we'll be at, updating everything that we need to do. And like I said, rollingburritosfoodtruck.com. We still have a Google Sheets survey on there. So fill it out, give us your options and what you desire. So Frank Baltieres, we're out of here.